Hi guys, in this video I'm covering Elastic Transcoder and Amazon Transcribe as well. Now for Transcoder, I'm just going to show you around the console and I'm going to give you a bit of information here because we haven't covered this service before. For Transcribe, we're actually going to use Transcribe in this lesson and upload a video file to an S3 bucket, and from there we'll do a transcription job where we'll actually extract the audio to a VTT file. So Elastic Transcoder is for transcoding video files. So you can take a video file from one format and then output it to various other formats or outputs. There's another service called Elemental Media Convert. That's a new service that provides more functionality and might be better for new use cases. Now there are some features that you can only get from Transcoder. These include WebM, VP8, VP9 input and output, animated GIF output, and MP3, FLAC, Vorbis, and WAV audio-only output. However, for many use cases, MediaConvert will give you more options, and it looks like AWS is pushing you in that direction. So let's head over to the console. I'm in the console here, and this is Elastic Transcoder. Now, straight away, you can see this is an older interface. This doesn't look like the new user interfaces that we're used to for most services. And at the top, you can see that AWS are trying to push people towards Elemental Media Convert. Now, if you do want to perform a transcoding job, you would create a new pipeline and submit your information here. Now, the other service is Media Convert. So there's a link at the top here to try Media Convert. And now we can see we're on a newer console and you can create a job here and input your various information for your inputs and then the output formats that you want. So you can see there's quite a lot going on here, and we won't be using this service in this lesson, but that's pretty much all you need to know for the exam anyway, just to understand that these two services, Transcoder and Elemental Media Convert, exist and what they do. So what we're going to use now is Transcribe. The first thing we need to do is create a bucket in which we're going to place our video file. So on S3, I'm going to create a new bucket. I'm going to call it transcribe dash, and then I'm going to put in a bunch of random characters to hopefully make it unique. And it's going to be in US East. So if I scroll down, I'm going to leave all of these settings and just create my bucket. Great, so I've got my transcription bucket. I'm going to go in and create a couple of folders. So the first one is going to be called input, and this is where I'm going to put my input files. So I'm going to create this folder, create another folder, and this is going to be output. And this is where I'm going to instruct the Amazon Transcribe service to save the output files. Now let's go into the input folder and I'm going to upload my video file. So I've got one called mytestvideo.mp4. You can use any MP4 video file that you want. So I'm going to upload this file, just choose upload. We don't need to do anything else. While that's happening, let's come over to Amazon Transcribe. And what I want to do here is go to transcription jobs on the left. I'm going to create a new job. I'm going to call it my transcription job. For specific language, I can choose the language that I want. So I'm going to choose English US. I'm going to leave the model types as general model. I'm not going to change any other settings here. And now we can choose the input data. So if I browse S3, choose transcribe, go to input, and I've got my video file. So I can select my video file. Next, for output data, we're going to choose customer specified S3 bucket. Again, browse S3, choose the bucket, and select the radio button next to output, and click on choose. The only other thing we need to do now is select the subtitle format that we want. I'm going to choose VTT, web VTT. You can also choose SRT if you want. You can specify both if you like, and you'll get both file types. So I've got VTT selected, and all I need to do is click on next. There's now a few optional job configuration settings we can apply, like audio identification, PII redaction, so that's personally identifiable information. So we might want to mask that information so it's not there in our files. Now I'm going to leave the settings as they are and simply create my job. So that job is now in progress and it shouldn't take long, probably less than a minute to complete. My job is complete now. You can look at some more information by going into the job, and here we can see things like the configuration settings, the start and finish times, and the input and output data location. If you use a bucket that's created by ES3, then you can actually see the transcription output here as well, but we chose our own. So all I want to do now is go to S3. Let's go to our output folder. So I'm going to go up one level, choose output, and you'll see a few files here. So the first one is the write access check. So that's just the transcribe service making sure that it can write to S3, and it did that first, just to make sure that before it continues with the job, it does have the permissions. So that's all that is. It doesn't mean anything else. There's a JSON. We've got the SRT and the VTT file. So you can now simply download your VTT file and that will be your subtitles. And that's it for this lesson. It's quite simple to use Transcribe for simple jobs like this. And also for more complex jobs, you can then use the API. For example, we actually use Transcribe for generating the subtitles or the initial subtitles for our course lessons. And we do get them touched up later on because they're not perfect, but they are quite good as a starting point. And we actually use S3 event notifications with two Lambda functions and Transcribe to actually do that for us. So that's it for this lesson. I will see you in the next one.